In the God of my salvation. How about you?
Amen. Worship
the Lord with us. Yeah. First vote is for Jesus. Amen. 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 We put Jesus back on the throne, we get everything straightened out.
Amen.
Amen. Hey, we're going to do something right now. We're getting ready to partake of communion. We want to just prepare our hearts. We want to just remember what Jesus did on the cross 2,000 years ago is not something to be taken lightly, but it's something we take with seriousness. It's something we take with great consideration. As we consider what he did for us when he went to that cross and gave his life. And those of you that are here, I know that, you know, in this life we have many, many battles. We face a very powerful and dark force. The powers of darkness are great. In fact, last night, my wife and I were sitting there at home, and we got a text message about a nephew of mine who was contemplating suicide. And we began to call out to get some support for us as we, Joyce and I gathered together in prayer. And right there in my living room, I fell on my knees, took my wife's hand, and together we began to pray. And we began to weep and cry out to God for his heart and for his soul. For you and I both know that when somebody's at the brink of suicide, the enemy is coming. He's attacking them with every dark and powerful force of evil to steal away their life, because he's come to what? Kill, to steal, and to destroy. But in that same verse, Jesus said, but I've come that you might have life. And life abundant. So you know what? As we begin to pray, within about an hour later, I called back to see how things were, and things have turned around. I just say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Folks, I don't know what you're facing right now, what you're going through, but I do know this, that the power that we've been given through prayer, the Bible says that a righteous man's prayers availeth much or accomplish much for the kingdom of God. And so when we pray, things happen. You may not see it, it may not happen this very moment. But I'm telling you something in the spiritual realm is going on. God is doing something. So we must continue to pray and pray in faith. So whatever you're facing or going through, or maybe a family member or a loved one is facing, we're going to lift those prayer requests unto the Lord right now. And will you stand together with us and believe God for breakthrough and miracles right now? Can you do that? Let's do it together, all right? Let's lift up our prayer request. Father, in Jesus' name, we come into your presence. And Lord, we are so grateful for the privilege we have of standing before the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the God of heaven and earth, created all things. We stand before you, Almighty God, knowing, Lord God, that you've made a way for us, not because of who we are, but because of the blood of Jesus, to enter into your throne and to lift up our requests before you. Thank you, Lord, that as we do, we can come in faith, believing you, trusting in you, knowing, Lord God, that you are more than able to do exceedingly abundantly more than we could ever ask or think. So we lift up prayer requests all over this place. Prayer needs. Lord, continue to do a work within my nephew's life. Lord, set him free. Break the powers of darkness over his mind and his heart. And let him know that you are his Savior, his Redeemer, and his Lord. Lord, draw him to you. For others, dear Lord God, that are lost without you, draw them to you. And do a mighty work to your glory and honor. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Lord, let us see what you're doing. Let us experience, dear Lord God, those breakthroughs. And we thank you. In Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. Amen. God bless you as we partake of communion. Communion stations are open. Lord bless you as you do so at this time. Amen. Please feel free to partake.
Jesus, you have won.
simply seems to be so strange. Freedom could be found through death and pain. Salvation paid for at the highest cost. Our redemption gained in heaven's loss. Oh, hallelujah. What can wash away my sin? Whosoever calls upon His name will find the guilt in murder on the way. Let our eyes up to their feet forever changed. Sing hallelujah. Thank you. keeping on. What a privilege it is for us to stand here today. Lord, we freely offer you our lives and all that we are and all that we have. But Lord, just like Pastor said, it's all yours. Not just the 10% that I give to my time, but Lord, all of it belongs to you. Lord, I pray that you'd help me to be a good steward over every part of it, every bit of it, all that 90% left. The way I give offerings, the way I invest it, the way I use it. The Lord, that I would be more effective in using it for your glory, for your kingdom, for the expansion of the kingdom of God, to reach lives, to reach souls, to see, Lord, even New Hope grow to a point, Lord God, that is beyond our imagination. Lord, let us be alive. We get ready to move, help me and each one of us to understand how we can invest and how we can give of our time, of our talent, and of our treasure into the kingdom of God. And Lord, we thank you even this week. Teach us, show us, lead us and guide us in your way. In Jesus' name we pray. And everyone said, amen. God bless you guys. And we'll see you next week.